these reports that this is it, Zika is it, so therefore take the birth control pill and don't get pregnant, and if you are pregnant, get an abortion, and, you know, sort of run the whole gamut. I mean, this sounds like one of those setups again, that, you know, the church is wrong, or you need to have an exception to the church's teaching, et cetera, all of this. You know, your thoughts. First of all, we don't even know the Zika virus causes any of this, do we?
No, there's been no direct evidence linking the Zika virus to the microcephalic changes that have been happening in the birth defects in children. And they're still in the process of evaluating its transmission. They know predominantly it's transmitted through mosquito bites from the Aedes mosquito. And there are endemic areas in the world. The United States is not one of them where these mosquitoes exist, but they also carry other types of viral infections. And we have a couple of reported cases now in the United States of some sexual transmission, finding out that the virus does in fact persist in seminal fluid for up to a few weeks after a male may be infected by a bite from an infected mosquito. So immediately everyone out there is running to, let's fund $1 billion to do research.
Yeah,
we're going to have a worldwide pandemic, and everybody should continue having intimate relations but use contraception. And when the contraception fails, then you should immediately abort because we don't want to bring any more birth defective children into the world.
Yep, that's pretty much the general routine. It happens every time anything comes out like this. Dr. Nadel, let me ask you, we have this this same sort of flow of things, except in your work, establishing the link between abortion and breast cancer, it's kind of the reverse situation. You have the establishment saying that your information isn't correct, unlike the Zika virus, where we have the case where we're saying, well, the establishment is correct, so the church is wrong. And, of course, they're coming up with the same conclusion in your work, that, again, the church is wrong and there is no link between abortion and breast cancer. So as you look at the Zika situation, what are your thoughts after having spent years in the trenches of this whole medical establishment versus the church?
Well, I agree with everything that was just said here. Is there a causal relationship that's been established? No, there hasn't been. If we take a look at things, they've done some pathology on the brains of babies with abnormally small heads that were aborted. And they found Zika virus DNA in those brains. They found Zika virus DNA inside of the placentas of those mothers. But again, does that really establish a causal relationship? You know, the analogy I like to use is, you know, we hear gunshots out on the street. I go out and I find you kneeling over the body in blood and, you know, with the gun in your hand. Now, is that causal? I mean, did you just happen on the scene and, you know, I come afterward and find you there? Does this mean that you killed the person? I don't know. We need to tease that apart. It's the same thing here. We don't know if this is causing these abnormally small heads to develop. We know, as you said in your lead-in, in your news report, that the larvicide that's sprayed stunts the growth of mosquitoes in the larval stage. Now, the question is, does this chemical have the same effect on human development? Does it affect the patterning genes during embryonic development? That we don't know. But I, you know, you brought up a good point, Michael. I think the other side, just, you know, the truth is irrelevant to them. It's only what, you know, how you want to spin it.
Never let a good crisis go to waste, right?